times that by five that. That video there that I've just showed you, 219 views or something. What's that, 80 pence for 1,000 views or something? On lower end ads. If that were helmets, it'd probably be about £1.40 or something, but it's no, innit? It's nothing, innit? It's just YouTube just getting money off of companies, innit? That's all. This is just an hobby, innit? But if this tool, YouTube, if this tool that we're using, or whatever they call it, concept, if this concept that I'm using here to interact with fans helps sell more tickets for Dennis's show and helps Josh Wale moving forward and helps my channel, that's good, you should get behind me. But like I said to you before, people get that damaged, right, by somebody like me. I mean, how dare I recommend that Josh Wale does some signs for Dennis Dobson when he's come to end of his tether with Steffi Bull, or end of his contract, sorry, with Steffi Bull. How dare I do that? And how dare? And how wrong it would be for people to let us move on. They have to give us stick, because that's just how it is, isn't it? That's just how it is. Well, like I said, Steffi will lose some more fighters, you know, next year, and that's just how it goes, isn't it? And Dennis might lose fighters next year. It's just boxing, isn't it? It's just how it goes. It's how you move forward and conduct yourself. And I'm trying my best to be very professional with this. I'm trying not to get out of my head, and sometimes I look at these comments and I think, do you know what? Jeez. It's a good job I'm mentally stronger. Otherwise, I might end up relapsing and going and taking heroin, and that's bad, isn't it? I've got kids. I don't want them to be around that. I want that. It's not good, is it? But drugs are for mugs, and boozers are not cruisers no more. Although every now and then I have to go on a mini cruise. Spending time in here, it's like a little prison. In fact, it reminds me of a prison with them breeze block walls there. But it's all good positive stuff. It's all good positive stuff, and I want everybody to get behind channel, get behind Porky's Corner, because we're going places. And hit that subscribe button. If you hit the subscribe button, you get your Porky notification straight away. So if you're new to the channel, whack it up and leave a comment. If you want to leave a bad comment, leave one, but leave a comment. Let me know what you think about the video. And let me know what you think about Josh Wale moving forward. Who do you think he should fight? Because it's all going to be revealed in 3 days, but who do you think Josh Wale should fight in June? We're talking a mega fight in June. Now, who do you think? Where do you think it should be at? And who do you think Josh Wale should fight? Do you think it should be a world champion? Like Warrington? Do you think that should be on an Oakwell? Do you think it should be on an Ellen Road? Do you think it should be a former world champion who's now fighting at featherweight? Do you think it should be that person? Could be anybody, couldn't it? I mean, the list here is, could be anybody. It could be people who've challenged for world titles. But the future is very, very, very sparkly and bright and looking well for Josh Wale, isn't it? He's looking well. He's having a whale of a time, and so is his dad, Mick. We're in Tenerife, sun in the sands like that, on a beach. Or we're all here shivering in Rotherham. But it's looking good, isn't it? And I'm glad everybody's getting behind Josh Wale and Porky's Corner and Dennis Hobson's Fight Academy. It's the place to be at the moment, isn't it? People keep saying to me that Sporting Icons is the place to be and Hatman Strikes Back. Well, these people don't come from behind the camera, do they? They're not in front of the camera like me, they're behind the camera, so I can't get behind her. although I have listened to it, and I think that they both got fantastic boxing knowledge. But with him being behind camera, they're probably reading off something, aren't they? Whereas me, I can keep it rolling. My engagement levels are 90-odd% on here. Their engagement levels are not like mine because they're behind the camera, aren't they? So, I'm not going to say it, but it is what it is, isn't it? But like I've just said to you, it's all good, positive stuff. What does upset me though with other YouTube channels is this. Hatman Strikes Back spends all day bigging up Eddie Hearn, going on about how many pay-per-view buys and discrediting all Eddie Hearn's rivals in every division, every weight division, and leaping to the defence of Dillian White and all that. Well, really, if Dillian White's cleared, if he's cleared, does it mean he's not guilty? We don't know, it's shrouded in mystery, but it's cleared, so we have to say, let's move on. But I want to see Dillian White sue Thomas Hauser and UCAD and BoxingScene.com and anybody else. I want Dillian to sue them all. I wanted Tyson Fury to go all the way, but he didn't. He accepted a backdated 2-year ban. Imagine that. Could you imagine that? That's like that man, isn't it, who were on death row 30 years in America. That black man. He were on death row all that time, or he was doing a life sentence, and they asked him, will you admit it and we'll let you out today, and he said no. So he ended up doing another 9 years, and then he got out. So, he got out. So, eventually. But you won't admit to something you've not done, would you? What sort of person does that? Why would you admit to something you've not done? If Tyson Fury's not took whatever he took, why admit it and get a 2-year backdated ban? I don't get that. I don't get it. But did that cause the cocaine and the refusal of the test and the depression? Probably. But I don't know, but you can are to blame for a lot of things. Well, we're going off track here. I'm pleased for Josh Wale, and he's having a lot of success, and I'm glad, like I said, I'm behind Josh, and I'm part of Team Wale, and I'm proud to be a team member of Josh Wale's team. Makes me proud. And like I said, it's a shame that they've moved on from Stiffy Bull. But it's just a shame that Steffi can't move on, is it? Hashtag levels, okay Steffi. Hashtag doing bits. So, but anyway, I think that's about it for today. I'm going to get these uploaded now. So peace out. Keep on trucking. Keep supporting boxing. Don't forget, hit that subscribe button. And hit the comment section, hit the like button, like and subscribe, and then you'll get your porky fix every day, because there's going to be loads of videos going out in the next 2 to 3 days. I'm going to batter it, alright? So, shout out to Stephanie Robertson from Bramley in Rotherham, the blonde haired lady. I did meet you outside the computer shop, and you were very polite to me. I didn't know what to say to you. It shocked me, I think. You coming up to me saying, are you that porky? It shocked me because my first name's obviously Russell, so at first it just shocked me. But don't be going out and buying tracksuits and trainers for me, but that's what size I am. But like I said, if they're your husband's old stuff that we don't want, send them down, I'll get them altered. But don't go out wasting your money. Spend it on your kids at Christmas. Alright, but thank you very much. But if you do it, don't be telling your husband, he might want to come down and film me in. It's only up here. Alright, Stephanie. Well, thank you very much. Thank you to all boxing fans for following the channel. It's going in the right direction. It says on here that we should be on 2,500 subscribers for end of year. 30th, is it? Oh, I must have lost a couple today. 3rd of January, we should be on 2,500. That's estimated. And it says we're on for 1 million views. 1 million views, 15th of March. So, we're progressing, aren't we? But then again, who were it? Were it Box Clever? Sent me a load of correspondence saying your channel's SHIT and all that. Well, what can you do? I think it's doing better than your channel, isn't it, Mr. Box Clever? Hashtag levels doing bits. So, alright. Peace out! I think I'm gonna have a light dumbbell workout now with these light dumbbells. And we'll do a bit of bench press. And I think I'm gonna finish putting my picture frames. Hope I've got some in the car. I've got some Frotch ones. Me and Frotch. We'll get them up, eh? Send you Frotch haters into meltdown. So, right, I think that's about it really. It's been a long day. So, like I said, we're going to be back tomorrow. And it's just a case of me waiting for my snooker cue now, I suppose. And I'm going to start doing a few trick shots. I'll do a few trick shots, cheer you all up. I'll have to get them spot on though, because if you miss, I can't edit. So I'll have to get them spot on, but it's all good. Shout out to Limitless. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the new year. And funkying my channel up. What do they call it? Funkying my channel. Jazzing it up, they said. They're going to jazz it up for me. Probably going to do a nice entrance. I do like that entrance that Boxing with Vadey's got at the beginning, but I've got a bit better than that lined up. I'm fortunate that I'm going to put quite a bit into the channel now at the moment, because I think it's time to go to the next level. And to do things like that, obviously, you've got to spend, haven't you? And with me not getting out of my face all the time, and I'm looking at packing in, going out even on a Friday now, looking at packing that in, so might as well put it into the channel, aren't we, and see how far we can take it. I'm going to see how far I can take this channel. I'm going to see now, because I'm free as a bird now. There's no partners. There's people helping me behind the scenes, but there's nobody. I'm not working with Nicola, obviously, it's the only partner I've had really in it. I'm not working with Nicola no more. I'm fitting things around Nicola's schedule. She works for Dennis now. So that's another story. But I wish her well, but I don't sometimes like doing it on my own, this channel. It's nice to have somebody there in it, but I'm having to make all decisions on my own, so I've got to be a little bit more wiser, haven't I? And it's no good me going out all the time, is it? Because you can't go out and burn a candle at both ends and do a YouTube channel. I've got to be taking it serious. And we're getting to part where it's getting pretty serious now, channel. It's the things we're going to add to it all the time. I mean, if you remember when I started, it were... I don't know what I was doing. I didn't know what I was doing. Pat, my friend, said to me, we practiced in my shed, I was all over the place, but now it's pretty easy, I'm pretty confident in front of the camera now, so, alright, so, okay, so I'll crack on and get these up, and then I'm going to go to, I'm off to JD Sports, is it Parkgate? I'm going there in about half an hour, so. And then I'm going home for my tea. So,
Alright, so shout out to Zeb from Leeds, who always defends me on the YouTube comments. Thank you very much, Zeb. It was nice to see you last week. You're a good bloke for a Scotchman. Very nice man. I think that's about it, really. So, alright, but don't forget to get your lists in for trainer of the year, fighter of the year, trainer of the year, manager of the year, and promoter of the year, and helmet of the, well, it's year, we always do the year one in December, helmet of the year. So it's fighter, trainer, manager, promoter, helmet, the big five. Fighter, trainer, manager, promoter, helmet of the year. All right, I want we're not going to do a media one, we're just going to do them five. So it's fighter, trainer, manager, promoter, helmet. All right, I have a good idea who's going to be winning it this year though. So, boom. Oh.